Hello, my friends. Today we're gonna have Maya in the video because she's very worried because it's a cat outside, and she won't let me make a video if I don't have her in my arms. So we're gonna talk about ascending in 5D, okay, in fifth dimension. What are the symptoms? Everybody says that we maybe feel physically, mentally, emotionally challenged without any particular reason or cause. If there is a cause and you feel challenged, it's different. But if you feel all this without a cause, then it's considered a symptom of ascension. The truth is that we are multidimensional beings. And we create our own multiverse. But when we say we ascend in another dimension, it means that we focus in higher vibrations, higher vibration thoughts, higher vibration feelings, higher vibration situations and manifestations. Everything in the universe is comprised of vibrations, including us. Actually, everything is information. The recent physics discoveries show that we live 99% in a universe which is digital. So everything is information. But we can name it. We need to call things with some names in order to have a code between us, in order to understand each other, right? So you can understand what it means, vibration. As a soul and as a vibratory spiritual energy being, you are also a light being. A light being who creates human life via the direction of your thoughts, your feelings, and your words. So you have to be very careful of your words, your thoughts, and your feelings. You already know that. But all of them together form your intention, right? And people around you can also influence what you manifest. Because the real power is the intention. And we said that intention has to do with our thoughts, our feelings, and our words. The more aware you are of the power that you have, the power to create, the power to destroy, then the more conscious you are and the more conducive your manifestations become. But what about other people, when the other people with their thoughts can influence our manifestations, maybe toxic people, etc.? Well, I tried a lot of years to stay close to everybody because I am a very sensitive person, and it's very hard for me to say goodbye to people and to stay away from people. But really, you can't go higher in vibrations or in your feelings, and some people can keep you very miserable. That's the truth. So one thing that we must do now that we are moving in a higher vibration, we must be careful to be away from toxic persons. And it's better anyway to create conscious experiences which uplift and inspire yourself, inspire others, rather than creating unconscious experiences, unwise choices which may cause you frustration or pain. All choice is within you. So another symptom of ascending in 5D is to be able to have more often lucid dreams. Lucid dreaming is when you realize that you are dreaming, and then you take the control of your dream. It's a wonderful experience. You can fly and you feel everything. It's great. It's really great. I will make videos on lucid dream as well. You know, there are a lot of seminars right now about lucid dreaming, but I see a lot of people when they read my book three times, because the book gives them a lot of new energy, ascension feelings, and they start to have lucid dream out of nowhere. Not everybody. Some of them need to learn techniques and need to have seminars with me about lucid dreaming. But a lot of people start now to have lucid dreams out of nowhere. Also, another symptom is to start to have non-physical communication, channeling. Yes. And some people don't know that there is channeling inside the matrix and channeling outside the matrix. So please focus your intention to have channelings outside of the matrix. So I will show you. I have a list here from a nice article that I found about some symptoms. So you can have headaches, migraines, fuzzy head, spiritual flu. This one is really strange. It's a combination of many of the physical symptoms listed. Even though you have flu-like symptoms, you are not actually physically ill. It's more of an energetic sickness that passes over 24 to 48 hours. It can often feel like a spiritual fire is rising within you, cleansing and clearing any toxic energy in your cells and bringing them up to a higher, finer vibration. If you have felt it, you really understand that's exactly as this lady describes here. Dizziness, ears receiving high vibration sounds. This will sound like a tuning fork being struck in one ear or the other. A high vibration sound slowly tunes in and then out. It doesn't hurt and is random and is not the same as tinnitus. Ear downloads are the way that high vibration 5D information is absorbed by your energy body. All is sound. You are receiving instructions on your next steps. You may not be able to decipher what the messages mean. Just pause, allow them to absorb and say thank you. So yes, at the beginning you can maybe feel like this. Later on, and when you get trained, you can realize that just the message is not really needed to hear sounds. But your intellectual, if it's not ready, will need a proof. And this proof can be translated in these strange sounds. It is exactly like the third eye opening. We don't need to feel anything when our third eye opens. It's just our intellectual, as Tom Campbell, the great physicist, explains to us, right? It's our intellectual that needs to have a feeling, to have a sensation in order to have a proof. This reminds me of Dr. Eric Perle and his book of Reconnection. Maybe some of you know that book. So what he says is that at the beginning, when he was receiving all this energy and he was healing people, he was healing a person who had a problem with his eye, and the eye was swollen and red and everything. And when he healed the person, immediately his own eye was like that. It was not necessary to happen, but his intellectual was needing proofs that he has healed the person. So he was needing that proofs, because he couldn't realize what's happening. You understand? So we don't need to hear sounds. We don't need the headaches. We don't need the dizziness. We don't need all that. But our intellectual needs that. Okay? So heart palpitations, blurry eyes, waking up about between 2 and 4 a.m. Well, it can happen strange things with sleep. For example, lately I am awake like, I don't know why, but it's exactly the number, 33 hours. 33 hours awake, 2-3 hours of sleep. 33 hours awake, 2-3 hours of sleep. And I can do many things. I feel that I have energy all the time. It's not a problem. But at the same time, I don't know how to explain this. I feel all this energy and I do everything. But at the same time, I feel tired. And maybe my intellectual thinking that, oh my God, I slept so little and I'm awake so many hours. Maybe it's my intellectual which thinks that I have to feel tired as well, you know? So, yes, I think it's that. But strange things with sleep. And what says here, the article, is this is the hour of the night when energy is still and soul becomes active. You can clear much from your mind if you awaken during this period. You are receptive to hear the voice of soul. Yes, and the truth is that if you are a writer or a painter or something, you see that you need to work this time of the night because everybody sleeps and all the vibrations of this, of the thoughts of that people are calm now. You know, there is not so much noise, vibrational noise on the atmosphere. So that's why writers write their books late at night. Painters paint their paintings late at night. It's really true. And here it says that greater clarity comes during these hours as your personality is quiet. Exactly. And this is what we want to kill. We want to kill the ego. We want to kill the personality. The personality is just our ego. So it says here, wake up, meditate, write down your thoughts. Then you, when you go back to sleep, it's likely you'll have prophetic dreams, dreams with important messages that you'll remember. Some people may even astral travel after going back to sleep, have an outer body experience and be conscious of life continuing on outside of the physical body while in the dream state. So yes, and lucid dream is a form of out-of-body experience. My easiest way of going out of body is when I have a lucid dream. So try it. If you have lucid dreams, inside the lucid dream, ask to get out of body. Is the best astral travel and the easiest way. Oh, Maya, I love you too. This is great. So sore muscles and joints, heat rising in the body, dropping objects, being clumsiness. This tends to occur when your paradigm has been challenged and your old ways no longer serve you well. You are being guided to change your ways, to focus more in the moment and not get distracted by many things at once. Anxiety. Many empaths may feel anxious because of the lower level of a negative energy that they pick up and absorb from others and the toxic environment. When there is a lot of cosmic activity, you could feel anxiety rise, accompanied by many of the physical symptoms from this list. If you are sensitive to others' energy fields, being aware of your abilities is a key. Pull your awareness in closer to your own energy field rather than extending it out to meet others. Look after yourself by focusing on what you love. Loss of memory. This often happens when you grow in self-awareness. You become more interested in the moment than the past. And hence, you may not even remember at a glance when you did what you did this morning by lunchtime today. You'll need to slow down your thinking in order to recall. High vibration energy 5D keeps you in the moment where all power and potential exists. Higher expectation from yourself and others. A relationship strains and changes, a growing need to break free, career dissatisfaction. You may need to change your work. Yes, you may need to follow that big dream, or to change towards art. And now, if you ascend, you start to use more your right brain. And your right brain is all this childlike spirit, team spirit. You know, now at the new earth, people who are self to service to self won't be able to be there. It's only service to others. We have to make choices of love. You have to have the work that you love, your passion to be your work. Even big business strategists now have new seminars, how to make money from your passion, how to make a great business from your passion. It's amazing what happens. Everything is changing around us. Maybe these business strategies don't do it consciously, or maybe they do. I don't know. But it's great. It's really great. I saw lately, and I was in the seminar, Jay Abraham, who is a great business strategist. And he had this seminar, how to do your hobby a business, how to turn your hobby into a successful business. So it was really great. And of course, a great need to find your mission, your purpose on earth. Why you came here on earth? What is your mission? You know, there was a huge call out on the universe from earth for years now. And we came here to help. We came here to help more people to ascend. We came here to help earth to ascend. So we live in wonderful times. It's really great. It's amazing. And everything around us is changing. And it's like Tom Campbell says, all the situation that we are living now, it seems like we lose our freedom. It seems like it's all this shadow that has to come outside, and we to see everything, to see the truth, and finally humans to see that they have to get rid of ego and they have to make choices of love. Otherwise, they can't be here. This is, I think, a sign from universe, a sign from the LCS, the larger consciousness system, as Tom Campbell calls the big computer that creates this reality. And it gives us a sign. It says, hey, wake up. Wake up. If you don't start to follow love, you can't be there anymore. You know? So please, let's all make choices of love and not choices of fear. Let's be compassionate. Let's become more empaths to feel the other person. In 5D, it's considered that we will feel the thoughts of the other person, right? And some of us already do. But in order to do that, first step is to start wondering what that person feels now when I talk to him or to her like this. Does he feels pain inside him? We have to become compassionate. We have to wonder in order to become more empaths, more bigger empaths, you know? And then we have to choose love and to wonder all the time, what love would do now? Even if someone yells at you, even if someone is bad at you, you wonder, what love would do now? I hope you liked this video, and I hope you share it with two of your friends, because I'm trying to have my audience back. Please share this video, and maybe you will help other people to become more compassionate and feel love inside them. Thank you, and I will be back soon. Love to all. And remember, love is the answer.